الصمد. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله، الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا، وانفعنا بما علمتنا، وزدنا علما يا أرحم الراحمين. Ask Allah عز وجل, teach us what benefit us from what He taught us, and increase us in knowledge. Ask Allah عز وجل put barakah in this gathering, and make us from the people at the end of the gathering, they will be told, قُومُوا مَغْفُورٌ لَكُمْ قَدْ بُدِّلَ سَيِّئَاتِكُمْ حَسَنَاتٍ. Get up, all your sins are forgiven, and your evil deeds are switched into good deeds. اللهم اجعلنا منهم يا رب العالمين. آمين. So this is our first halaqa after the terrible incident that took place in New Zealand. After we left Thursday night, we were informed that night about the tragic event, and I dedicated the khutbah on Friday, which I really recommend that everybody watches. And the title of the khutbah is The Only Solution. We seek many solutions, and we take by the means, by having security and all that, which is good, alhamdulillah, to take by the means. But if you're looking for the real solution, listen to the khutbah, inshallah ta'ala. That is the only solution that is told to us by Allah Azza wa Jal. A solution that is only the only way that we will be saved in the dunya and in the akhirah. And always keep in mind, we spoke also after Fajr on Sunday, and we mentioned, one brother asked me if I can make dua against the man who did this. And the answer is absolutely yes. You can make a dua against him. And the dalil is in Bukhari and Muslim, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stayed 30 days making dua after every salat, or at the last rak'ah of every salat, make dua al-qunut on the people who killed the 70 sahaba. So one quick note, inshaAllah ta'ala, is that, you know, we do not know where the khair is. We do not know where the khair is, but we all know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only decrees khair, even though it might not look that way to us. But subhanAllah, you're going to see gradually, and we are already seeing how many people have taken shahada, and how many people are inquiring about Islam. And subhanAllah, that masjid became a mazar. You know, so the people who established the masjid, which was one of them, was killed. May Allah have mercy on him, Brother Ata. His wife is a close friend of a sister that we know right here. And subhanAllah, somebody sent me a picture with him. He was very close to a brother that I know also in Greece. So subhanAllah, yani, the father built that masjid. Now so many people are coming to pray in that masjid, and inshaAllah ta'ala, all that ajr will get to the people. And subhanAllah, asa an takrahu shay'an wa huwa khayrun lakum. You might hate something, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put in it a lot of khayr. A lot of khair. And we mentioned that, subhanAllah, how many people died and the whole ummah make dua for them? Very few. These people, subhanAllah, almost every Muslim that found out had made dua either in his sujood or his imam in the masjid. So subhanAllah ta'ala, it's always good, even though for us it does not look good. So tonight's name, inshaAllah ta'ala, is a name that we have taken something close to it, which is the name we took was Al-Adl. Today's name is Al-Hakam. Al-Hakam. Al-Hakam is one of the names of Allah Azza wa Jal, which is also close to the name Al-Hakim. And they are both derived from the three-letter verb Ha, Ka, Mim. Ha, Kaf, Mim. Al-Hakam means the judge, the giver of justice, the arbitrator. Occur only once. It mentioned only once in the Quran. أَفَغَيْرَ اللَّهِ أَبْتَغِي حَكَمًا. أَفَغَيْرَ اللَّهِ أَبْتَغِي حَكَمًا. It is other than Allah I should seek a judge. And that is in Surah, if I'm not mistaken, Surah Al-An'am. Al-Hakam never wrongs anyone and is never oppressive. He is the only true judge. No one can overturn his judgment and no one can ever appeal his decree. Hakam comes refers to the attribute of judging, being wise, passing a verdict and preventing mana'. Also al-Hakam means al-mana', preventing, restraining people from wrongdoing. So al-Hakam yamna' al-dhulm. The Hakam, he prevents dhulm from taking place. It was mentioned in a hadith for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam one time, a man came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he heard someone being called Abu al-Hakam. Abu al-Hakam, father of al-Hakam. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called him and said, Allah is al-Hakam. Yani Allah is al-Hakam and your name is Abu al-Hakam? The father of the Hakam said, Allah is the Hakam and judgment is his. Why are you being called as Abu al-Hakam? Why people call you Abu al-Hakam? So the man said, if my people differ concerning something, they come to me and I pass judgment among them. And both sides accept it. So people take him as a Hakam of the village. They agree to his decision. He said, MashaAllah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, how good is this? This is something amazing that you are making suluh and people respecting you. How good is this? Do you have any children? You know, look at the sloop, you know. He wants to change his name, but in a nice way. Do you have any children? He said, yes, I have three. He said, what's the name of the oldest? He said, Shurayh. He said, your name is Abu Shurayh. So he changed his name from Abu al-Hakam his name is not even Abu Hakam. Abu al-Hakam with Alif Lam, which is dangerous. Abu al-Hakam, yeah. So he said, you are Abu Shurayh. SubhanAllah. So here where we see the name al-Hakam mentioned. Al-Hakam is that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us in one hadith, the reality of Iman is knowing that what has passed you by was not going to befall you, and that what has befallen you was not going to pass you by. This is a main tenet of faith. This is a main foundation, that whatever happened to me is already Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed it, and no matter what happened, it's not going to pass by. And whatever missed me, and this is happens a lot with the people who do business, they think sometimes that they missed a deal, they missed a good offer on real estate and anything, a close out, and they think that if I did this, if I did that, if I was there, if I was a little bit earlier, if I did not miss the plane, if I if qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if opens the door of Shaitan. So we do not say if we say قدر الله وما شاء فعل. Listen to this, Ikhwan. This is a statement that we should teach our children. قدر الله وما شاء فعل. Whatever Allah has decreed, He has already done. And we teach our children that, you know, when something bad happens or something that you were not expecting happens, قدر الله وما شاء فعل. I told you the story before when my kids were very young. I told them this dua. If something happens, خلاص, you did not expect it, do not get upset and do not get mad. Just say, قدر الله ما شاء فعل. So one time my son missed the bus to go to school. And I have to go to work, I'm late. So I have to go drive him. You know, I was frustrated. How did you miss the bus? And I have to be at work. And so I, yalla, get up, and we in the middle of the in the middle, oh Baba, I forgot my glasses. You forgot your glasses? He said, Baba, قدر الله ما شاء. Ya Allah, you have to be careful what to teach you. So, you know, subhanAllah. So it's good that he remembered that. At least something good came out of it. And I remembered that, you know, you have to control yourself sometimes. Whatever you teach and preach, you have to practice. So, قدر الله وما شاء فعل. Part of believing in Allah al-Hakam is to know that the rulings that Allah, this is very important. Part of believing in Allah al-Hakam is to know that the rulings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have told us, they came from Al-Hakam. They came from the all-wise and the all-knowing and the all-just. Sometimes we complain, what is this Fajr is too early? What is this fasting in August? What is this, before I forget, inshallah, the three white days are Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. Before I forget, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday are the three white days of Rajab, inshallah ta'ala. So do not complain about any hukm of Allah. What is this hijab in a hot weather? Why do I have to cover my whole body? Why this is haram? Why this is, no. Keep in mind that these rulings, whether they are orders or they are prohibitions, they came from the Hakam, the all-just, the all-knowing and the all-wise. So even though sometimes I might not know the hikmah, the wisdom which came from the word Hakam, by the word, even though Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned once al-Hakam in the Quran, but the words derived from it, يَحْكُمُ أَحْكَمَ الْحَاكِمِينَ أَلَيْسَ اللَّهُ بِأَحْكَمِ الْحَاكِمِينَ, right? So all these are derived from the word al-Hakam, but al-Hakam is only mentioned once. So even though sometimes I'm not convinced or I'm not sure what is the hikmah, I have to take it that this definitely good for me, whether I understand or I do not understand. Now, when it comes to the, you know, in I don't know in Urdu, but in Arabic, usually al-Hakim also is the ruler of the same ruler of a city is called al-Hakim, and Hakam is you know, the referee in the soccer game or any kind of game is called Hakam also. He is the one who is going to rule who the offside penalty. He is the Hakam also, and even the Qadi. The Qadi, the judge, is also, he is the one who performs the hukum. So, listen to this, subhanAllah. You know, if you study the seerah of all our salaf, all our righteous predecessors, you will notice that they used to run away from which job? Qudat. Run away. Not like, you know, no, please, I don't want it. No. Run away, move, run away like Sufyan al-Thawri, run away, not to be a qadi. Why? Listen to this hadith. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, al-qudat, the judge, or the judges, qudat is plural, qadi is one, qudat is plural. Al-qudat thalatha. Judges are of three kinds. Two of them are in hell, and one is in Jannah. Now you know why people run away. Two out of three. Why? رجل قضى بغير الحق فعلم فهو في النار. Someone ruled with a false ruling, and he knew that this was false. He's in hell. This is clear. We all know this one. But the second one, وقاض لا يعلم فأهلك حقوق الناس فهو في النار. He is not, this is happens a lot in our country, he's not qualified to be a judge. He does not know. Because of his ignorance, he led many people to jail or to be oppressed. He's in hellfire. You know, the first one, clear. He did it on purpose. But the other guy, he does not know the ruling. And that also applies to a mufti. Ya Habibi, you do not know. Somebody comes to you, لا أدري, لا أعلم. Someone comes to you and asks you a question about the deen. Do not be ashamed. Do not be shy. I am Brother Bajur. I do not know the answer. Let me give him something. No. لا أدري. I do not know, Allah, يا أخي. I'll try to find out for you. Ask somebody else. But do not give an answer. This is similar. You do not know and you gave a fatwa. No, do not. Do not be tempted to answer without knowledge. And the third one is clear. وَقَادٍ قَضَى بِالْحَقِّ فَذَلِكَ في الجنة. And a qadi, a judge who ruled with haq, he is in Jannah. And subhanAllah, Sufyan al-Thawri, when rahimahullah, when he was asked, why you keep running away from being the qadi al-qudat, supreme judge, what we call right now, يعني, right under the ruler, right under Amir al-Mu'mineen, he said, because I am afraid, I am so worried, because I'm taking money from them for my living, for my sustenance, I might be tempted to give them ruling that's pleasing to them. You know, because he's taking the income from them. Maybe sometimes, like this is very popular right now. Come on, give us a fatwa that this is halal, this is haram. Bismillah. اشتروا بآيات الله ثمنا قليلا. They bought with the deen, very cheap price, dunya, subhanAllah. And we're seeing it a lot lately. Like I mentioned last week, a sheikh that used to say music is haram is dancing right now. No, they say it's okay, there's nothing wrong with it, and this is okay, this is okay, subhanAllah. Now, one of the words that come, or since we're talking about the fatwa, is something very important. Please, ya akhwan, you know, sometimes shaitan plays with our mind, and we go and seek a fatwa, and when we are seeking a fatwa, we do not give the proper information. Listen to what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Rasulullah, the biggest mufti, the first mufti, and the best mufti, right? No mufti, he's the one who started the fatwa. He said, I am, subhanAllah, just another proof that he is a human being. He does not ya'lam al-ghayb. I am only a human being, and you people have disputes. I am a human being, and you have fights and disputes. Maybe some of you can present his case in a better, more eloquent way and convincing manner than the other. And I give my judgment in his favor according to what I heard. Okay? This is very clear so far, right? Everything understand? Everybody understand? Okay. Now listen to the end. Beware. If ever I give somebody something of his brother's rights by error, then he should not take it as I have only given him a piece of the hellfire. Do you understand? If you come and you said to the sheikh, listen, ya sheikh, wallahi, he did this to me, this is the proof, and you got so, you were very convincing, and you know inside that's not your right, but you want to get a fatwa. And like Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, he just judged what information you gave him. Yeah, Sheikh, I was traveling from here to here, and I arrived this. When can I pray? He's judging according to what you're telling him. He's not going to come up with something new. If you know that he ruled in something that does not belong to you, you got yourself a piece of hell. So do not feel like, got it, got the fatwa. No, be careful. Be careful. SubhanAllah. And ya akhwan, another thing about the name of the hakam, of course we all know that the word hikmah comes from the word hakam, same root, ha, kaf, mim, hikmah, wisdom. We have to have hikmah in the way we deal with people, in the way we deal with our spouses, in the way we deal with our people at work, in with everybody. Even when we ask our elderly, we have to have hikmah. When we speak to our children, you have to have hikmah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يُؤْتِي الْحِكْمَةَ مَنْ يَشَاءَ وَمَنْ يُؤْتَى الْحِكْمَةَ فَقَدْ أُوْتِيَ خَيْرًا كَثِيرًا. Wallahi, I experienced this in my life. Allah said, He gives wisdom to whomsoever He chooses. And whomsoever got the wisdom from Allah, listen, I got goosebumps. Allah said, He got خَيْرًا كَثِيرًا. He got a lot of khayr. Because he knows that, you know what, this is not the time to say this. This is not the time to go there. This is not the time to raise your voice. This is not the time to stay quiet. This is not the time to do this. You know, this person, you talk to him in this manner. This person is edgy. He has hikmah. He knows when to speak, what to say, and to whom he's speaking to. It changes everything according to the people he's talking to. This is hikmah. When you present something, when you ask something, you know, ask with hikmah, ask with wisdom, you know, and be realistic sometimes. Sometimes we ask for things that are not realistic, and we insist and we scream. And some incidents happened in front of me that, you know, one time, you know, a brother, you know, he was complaining that the time of Fajr is wrong. And it was a day, you know, first day of Ramadan or whatever. To prove that the time of Fajr is wrong, he stood up right after the Adhan and he got a bottle of water and he started drinking. after the Adhan of Fajr in the day of Ramadan, because that's not the time that he goes by. Is this hikmah? And the people are sitting watching you drink. Tayyib ya akhi, you do not follow this. Alhamdulillah, Rabbi, I mean, it's up to you. It's okay. But you do not go and drink water in front of the people. This is not hikmah. You have to use hikmah. Try to talk to the imam, talk to me, talk to the management. But you do not, you know, if I don't like something, I'm going to make everybody knows that, you know, I don't. You know, you have to have hikmah in everything that you want. And with hikmah, you would get, inshaAllah ta'ala, whatever is pleasing to Allah Azza wa Jal. And also, Allah, I will finish with two more things. Number one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sometimes, ya akhwan, you have an issue between you and your wife. Or my sister, you have something wrong between you and your husband. Number one, you keep it between yourself. Try not to get it out of the house. Number two, try to solve the problem amongst yourselves. Try to do your best. Number three, we go by what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَإِنْ خِفْتُمْ شِقَاقَ بَيْنِهِمَا فَبْعَثُوا حَكَمًا مِنْ أَهْلِهِ وَحَكَمًا مِنْ أَهْلِهَا. Then let someone, a judge from her family and judge from his family, a responsible person from each family, let them negotiate and try to solve the problem. So this is the ruling of Allah Azza wa Jal. You do not immediately, the D word, this is very popular right now. Any small thing, divorce. Any small thing, divorce. No, ya akhi, what divorce? Well, there are so many steps before you go into that. You don't know, especially if you have children, you have to think. You have to think before you get into that that decision. SubhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He told us I couldn't find it right now. Oh, He said that, listen to this ayah. He said, فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ. Allah is making a qasam. فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ حَتَّى يُحَكِّمُوكَ فِيمَا شَجَرَ بَيْنَهُمْ. Ya Muhammad, by your Lord, they are not believers until they make you, whether you are alive or you passed away, whether they make you as their judge. The Quran and the Sunnah is the judge. We make you as their judge. If you do not go, especially us living here in the West, and it happens also since we're talking about divorce, I want divorce according to the American law, because I get half, right? But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that you are not a believer until you believe in what Allah and Muhammad said. يُحَكِّمُوكَ فِيمَا شَجَرَ بَيْنَهُمْ ثُمَّ لَا يَجِدُوا فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ حَرَجًا مِمَّا قَضَيْتْ وَيُسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. They make you the judge. They accept the judgment with pleasure and they are taslim. They submit to it. No argument. They will not find anything in their heart against it. Khalas, Allah and His Prophet said that. Bismillah. Bismillah. And finally, dua, subhanAllah. Rasulullah ﷺ started this hadith by saying, whomsoever have any kind of stress, grief, depression, hem, hazan, sadness, if he says this dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take away his distress and his grief. What is that dua? Allahumma inni abduk, ibnu abdik, ibnu amatik, nasiyati biyadik. This is why we're not narrating it. Madin fiyya hukmuk, adlun fiyya qada'uk. أسألك بكل اسم هو لك سميت به نفسك أو علمته أحدا من خلقك أو أنزلته في كتابك أو استأثرت به في علم الغيب عندك أن تجعل القرآن ربيع قلبي ونور صدري وجلاء همي وذهاب حزني. الله أكبر. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said, if anyone heard this hadith, let him teach it. And inshallah, I'm doing my job. Huh? Anyone heard this hadith? Let him teach it. Let me just translate it quickly. Ya Allah, I'm your slave, the son of your slave, the son of your female slave. My forelock is in your hand. Your command over me is forever executed, and your decree over me is just. Your decree over me is just. I ask you by every name belonging to you, which you have named yourself, or revealed in your book, or you taught to any of your creation, or you have preserved in the knowledge of the unseen with you, that you make the Quran the life of my heart and the light of my chest and the departure of my sorrow and the release of my anxiety. You would think after all this introduction, Ya Allah, you know this, I ask you with every name, you would think, relieve my stress, right? Because the dua is to relieve the stress. What does it say at the end? Make the Quran the spring of my heart. Allahu Akbar. Wow. I'm asking for to be happy and joyful and out of that means, Ya Akhwan, the happy or the further you are from the Quran, the more depressed you are. This is the conclusion from this hadith. Very, very obvious. The further you are from the Quran, Now, Rasulullah said that the Quran, make the Quran Rabi'ah. Like Dr. Yusuf said, if you are far from the Quran, becomes winter, not Rabi'ah. Rabi'ah is spring. So you want to keep it spring. Okay, the closer you are to the Quran, the more the possibility of, no, not the possibility, the definitely, you will be happier. You will know something happened to you. قُلْ لَنْ يُصِيبَنَا إِلَّا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَنَا هُوَ مَوْلَانَا. You are depressed and you passed by this ayah. Whatever happens to me, have already decreed by my Allah Azza wa Jal. You'll always find something. والضحى والليل إذا سجى ما ودعك ربك وما قلى. Don't think Allah is not aware of what you're going through. So always there's something in the Quran. So Ya Akhwan, we derive today, you know, from this beautiful name Al-Hakam, Ya Ahkam Al-Hakimin, Ya Allah, you know, to make a relationship with the Quran. Page, 2 pages, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, anything you can per day, insha'Allah ta'ala, hoping that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make the Qur'an the rabi' of our hearts. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect our children. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect our spouses. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect our parents and grant them the highest place in Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unite our hearts always. May Allah azza wa jal increase us in iman. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana wa asrafana fi amrina wa thabbit aqdamana wa ansurna ala al-qawm al-kafirin. Rabbana atina fi dunya hasana wa fi al-akhirati hasana wa qina adab al-nar. Rabbana لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك، نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت، نستغفرك ونتوب إليك.